to our special Australia Day edition of the Trophy Room. And on our National Day, I think it's only right that we stop and remember what's truly important to our great nation. Sport and public holiday! Yeah! And we do hope you've had a great day, whatever you've been up to. Barbies, backyard cricket, starting a riot, maybe just getting a tat. But maybe you're an Australia Day ambassador, handpicked for your leadership skills, your charisma, but most of all, your unique way of communicating. And it seems tonight, she was recently named the most valuable player for the third time in the toughest women's basketball comp on the planet, America's WNBA. She's one of the best players in the world. She is Lauren Jackson! She's one of our favourite comedians and one of mine. You can see him soon at the Adelaide Fringe Festival. Please welcome a good mate of mine, Tom Gleeson! Thanks for joining us. Now, obviously, you're one of the greats over there in the US. How do the Americans respond to an Aussie being so good at their sport?
I think that, you know, being over there so long now, I don't even think they see me as a, you know, a foreigner. It's, you know, obviously, I'm really proud to be Australian. I shout Australia everywhere I go.
That'll get annoying for your teammates, I imagine.
Oh, no, absolutely.
You yell Australia out a lot.
Australia!
Now, Tom, you've just got back from performing in Afghanistan, which I think is a very
brave. I've got that a lot. For a non-contact sport, it's pretty fierce.
It is. If it's too much contact, I believe it's that.
Yeah,
that's okay, what's the beginning of this BMX race, and tell me what happens next. Okay, they're ready to go. And we got to stop it there. What happens next? Tom, I think I've seen this. The barrier doesn't open. And they all fall over.
I hope you're right, Tom.
Here we go. They're ready to start and go. Oh! Which member of the Australian coat of arms is alleged to have mauled the world's number one ranked? This is a great story. Caroline Wozniacki said she was attacked by a kangaroo. let's have a look at the apology.
The kangaroo story. Now, I made that because it sounded better than what actually happened. I walked into the treadmill, so it wasn't really, you know, that's my blonde sometimes, that happens.
At the 2000 Olympics, whose hair extension did...
What was the question?
At the 2000 Olympics, whose hair extension did Lauren Jackson rip out during the gold medal match?
It was no, actually that's not correct. I didn't rip out anybody's hair. It was an accident.
Well, but you can still rip out somebody's hair by accident.
No, it
was that's what happened to me.
Oh yeah.
Come on, hey. Ages ago. This is not a prep
conference.
Tell us why you did it.
What did you do? Oh my god. Everyone thinks I'm the nastiest person in the world because of that incident.
Well, what happened? I mean, I thought you were a legend straight away. Okay, I'll rephrase the question. At the 2000 Olympics, whose hair extension fell on the floor near Lauren Jackson? Completely innocent.
Okay, it was Lisa Leslie.
That's correct! What's this? Maybe for the panel, send your panel advice.
Probably for Lauren, which is pushing the button, you have to go smooth at it.
Fantastic. Held by an Aussie, the meat pie eating champion, but it actually turns out to be held by a Pom.
It's
disgusting, isn't it, Lauren Jackson?
Terrible.
Yeah. This is losing the Ashes wasn't enough.
I know.
This is worse. Fastest to slowest. What do you reckon the fastest was?
Okay. I do know this. Solving the Rubik's Cube is very fast. Like the people who do it, it's like 5 seconds or something.
5 seconds.
I reckon something like that. Yes, it's really quick.
So you reckon that's the fastest?
Well, the pie could be the fastest.
We do have the wheelbarrow over there. Why don't? The interesting thing about this record, there was a person in it at the time, and that person was weighing about 50 kilos. Yeah.
That was
very fast.
Minutes?
Yeah, that was quick. There's pies, there's Rubik's Cubes to consider. I reckon the fastest.
I'm not clear on the pies, because if you only had to eat one pie,
and
if it
was
really quick.
And if it was boiling hot too, you know.
I reckon the temperature wasn't an issue. I reckon they wouldn't have had a pie being hot.
You have to know where the pie came from too, because if it came from the bakery...
We don't have this information! It'll be a fun little segment of
the party pie!
It wasn't a party pie! It wasn't a party pie! It was not a party pie! fire. We don't know if it was me, to be honest. It was, listen, assholes, I don't know what it was. But it was a pie, a traditional pie. I don't know how hot it was. I don't know who cooked it.
Okay, was it?
Okay.
Can I ask one more question?
Yes.
Was it from the server? Plastic wrappers are hard to get off sometimes. Yeah. Like, that was factored into the pie.
This is like watching an old age pensioner. Yeah, do their shopping and then determine if they have eight items or less.
Yeah.
The Rubik's Cube was at room temperature.
Yeah, I reckon the pie's number one. It's going to take 3 seconds to demolish that, sure.
Okay.
Right, so pie number one, yeah. Rubik's Cube. And what do we say for the wheelbarrow?
Well,
we
did
it
in
30 seconds.
Yeah,
so yeah, 30 seconds. Wheelbarrow
next?
Yeah, I reckon wheelbarrow. Let's go to wheelbarrow.
Okay. And then cycling and swimming.
Okay, what's... Yeah.
I think maybe cycling, sure, it's on land. It would have to be quicker, wouldn't it?
Walking
it in? Yeah, go cycling and then and we'll make the slowest thing the 100 metre swim.
Yeah, I have no idea if that's...
Who was the first Aussie player to compete in the WNBA?
Michelle Timms.
Michelle Timms was correct. In fact, the first foreign player to ever play in the WNBA.
Yeah, that's an extra point. Lauren was the first foreign player to win the WNBA's MVP. Is that true?
Yeah.
Are you sure it's true? Yep. Well, I don't have the information in front of me. Is it true?
Actually, maybe. Yeah, no, it is true. It is true.
Sure? I'll give you a point. Which Aussie surf? Wow! That is full time. Tonight's winners of the trophy, Team Adams! There we go. Sorry guys, hang on a sec. I got that wrong, sorry.
You've got all the experience here, Lee.
Hand it back. I just want to say congratulations.
I feel a bit bad now. The winner's the Team Amanda! It was 36-38. Congratulations. And please, back again.